A very good afternoon to all participants, both physically attending and online attending. And my topic is about ammonia bunkering. And as you know, ammonia is a green fuel with no carbon. So in the future, when we have ammonia bunkering operation and facility in Singapore, there will be some issues to consider. And my study is actually focused on the creation of ammonia bunkering process, as well as the simulation of ammonia release. So this is the overall flow of my presentation. I start with ammonia, general introduction, and follow this. I will compare ammonia as a cargo and a bunker, and followed by ammonia bunkering process, safety considerations, simulation software, and some selected simulation results. So this is a general slide describing ammonia as a green fuel in the future. And green ammonia can be produced from green hydrogen, green electricity, and nitrogen captured from the air. And at this moment, there are several ongoing projects on the application of ammonia used as a marine fuel to power many types of marine ships. And this is a very detailed comparison between ammonia used as a cargo, chemical cargo, and as a bunker. And in this comparison table, I won't spend too much time here. Later, you can read one by one. And all these differences and gaps to overcome for ammonia bunkering is actually highlighted here in a red color. And before we start the process building, we need to consider the three different physical states of ammonia transferred as a liquid. First, we actually look at the fully refrigerated ammonia at minus 33 degrees Celsius. And there are also semi-refrigerated ammonia stored at minus 10 degrees to 4 degrees. And in Singapore, we can actually our ambient temperature is from 20 to 37 degrees. And in this range, we call it non-refrigerated ammonia. And we have to rely on pressure to make sure ammonia stay at liquid state. So by combination, you can combine ammonia from a bunker vessel to bunker receiving vessel in three different physical states. So if you also consider the cassette bunkering concept, we end up with 33 possible bunkering configurations. And on the bottom, we actually take three photos in Singapore showing the ship-to-ship bunkering, simultaneous operation, and truck-to-ship bunkering, which are quite popular here. And this is a very elaborated process telling you how to create this ammonia bunkering operation process. It's quite similar to other marine fuel bunkering, starting from the preparation, bunker transfer, to the post-bunkering operations. And for each step, we actually have many considerations. And I don't want to elaborate them one by one. And later, when we release our public report, you can refer to the report for each discussion and all these considerations. And how the bunkering process look like. And this process, we actually take a good reference from LNG bunkering. And this is the process we designed for fully refrigerated ammonia and semi-refrigerated ammonia. And some highlight of the process is that we use one hose connection between the bunker supply vessel and bunker receiving vessel. And we also use a nitrogen to purge the bunker line before and after bunkering. And one important highlight is that we use a vent scrubber to vent off the operational ammonia release. And this is another case for non-refrigerated ammonia bunkering, because in this case, everything will be at the same temperature, ambient temperature. So there is no pre-cooling line. So you can see that several lines are not demonstrated here. And we also have to rely on the bunker transfer pump to kick back all the remaining ammonia after the bunkering operation, so that you can notice on the lower left side, there is a red line, which is a must-have for ammonia bunkering as compared to fully refrigerated and semi-refrigerated cases. So once we have the ammonia bunkering process established, what are the main considerations? First of all is the toxicity, and the second is the flammability of ammonia. After we do a comparison of this range of toxicity and flammability, you notice that the toxicity can happen at very small concentration, from 30 ppm to 1,100 ppm. But when it comes to flammability, you have to reach 150,000 ppm to make it a real concern. So in our study and simulation, we take the toxicity of ammonia as a basis to run the simulation. And this is a simulation software we are using to simulate ammonia leakage and dispersion in a very big three-dimensional space. And this software is called FAST. And on the lower right, you can see what will happen after an ammonia release during a ship-to-ship bunkering. Ammonia will rain out as a liquid and form a liquid pool on the sea surface, and it will flow together with seawater, and of course, it will evaporate and absorbing heat from the environment and form ammonia cloud, which can be further diluted by air to reduce its concentration, and eventually it will disappear. So before we run the simulation of several different scenarios, we did a sensitivity analysis. We actually studied the operational parameters and the weather parameters, because all these parameters are the common influencing parameters for ammonia bunkering operations. And this is the area we selected in the southwestern Singapore within the port limit. We selected for ship-to-ship bunkering at an anchorage and the truck-to-ship bunkering at a jetty and the shore-to-ship bunkering at a terminal for our simulation. The first case is a ship-to-ship bunkering from the bunker ship to a container ship. And on the right-hand side, you can notice this is an ammonia cloud, the footprint of an ammonia cloud in daytime and nighttime. And we realized that there are some differences between daytime dispersion and nighttime dispersion. In daytime, the cloud actually travels a longer distance than that of the nighttime. But it's not enough just to understand the cloud coverage. We need to understand how dangerous are this ammonia cloud. So we use another criteria, which is called lethality footprint, to define this ammonia leakage. As you can see, the spindle-shaped the footprint is actually called lethality footprint. We actually combines ammonia concentration together with exposure time in this case. So there will be no time element in the final result. You can notice as a function of a wind blows, how this spindle shape looks like with different probability of lethality and what is the coverage of this spindle. So we did similarly for truck to ship bunkering following the same methodology. In the first case, we also, because in this case, the total leakage quantity is very small. It's only 200 kilogram. So the cloud coverage is very small. And also when it comes to the lethality footprint, the radius is around 70 to 80 meters. And the difference between daytime dispersion and nighttime dispersion is also quite small. We also did one case on shore-to-ship bunkering. And in this case, the release quantity is much larger, and the footprint of the ammonia cloud is also bigger and longer lasting. And this is similarly, we did the lethality footprint, and in both cases, in daytime and nighttime, the radius can be up to 370 meters to 400 meters. And I would like to highlight that for all these three scenarios, we are not considering any mitigation method. So in the future, I believe there will be mitigation measures after ammonia release so that can greatly or significantly reduce the footprint of lethality. So this is my last slide. I would like to conclude that ammonia bunkering, it is possible, and there are processes in our study developed for fully refrigerated, semi-refrigerated, and non-refrigerated ammonia transferring during the bunkering process. And we can do a far-field simulation using software, which can give us a lot of useful information for our future planning and infrastructure establishment. And we also would like to thank our project partners from ASTI all the way to Total Marine Fuels. You can see this list is actually growing. And we are going to release our public report by the early of 2022, next year. So I will be very glad to share our findings and results with all industry partners. And for further inquiry, please do contact this email and send your inquiries to MESD. And we are more than happy to collaborate further. Thank you very much.